Hi, welcome back for another Fuseday. I've had to prioritize some other deadlines, but today I'm back and I have a quick tip for you on how to place objects in a 3D track shot. It's a pretty easy process once you know how to do it. I didn't know it myself until fairly recently, so I decided to share it with you. At the end of the video, I will also be sharing a setting file that I created to make placing objects into the scene even easier. So stay tuned for that as well. Now let's dive into it.
Here is a shot from the Action VFX practice library that I 3D tracked. First, I used a regular tracker to mask out the moving car with an inverted rectangle mask. Then I did a camera track, solved and aligned the scene so that the origin of the scene is about here. Now in the past, if I wanted to place an object in the scene like this street light, I would for example choose a tracker that matched the location I wanted the light to be in. Then I would right click and select publish. This would give me the X, Y and Z coordinates that I would then have to republish, and then I would go into the transform tab of the streetlight and right click connect the XYZ values to the published values.
Okay, this works, but please do not do this. It makes changing the position of the streetlights afterwards more difficult, and we all know that our clients change their minds all the time. So if they wanted another type of streetlight, we would have to go through all these steps all over again.
Now here's the thing that I only recently discovered. When you right click on the tracker point, you see various options. Create shape, create align shape, create image plane, create locator, and these all have their uses. But the one that is the most useful for our purpose is this one. Copy point position. Because if I select this option and then click in my flow view and press paste, I get a transformed 3D node that has the coordinates of my tracking point. And this exists as its own thing. So in this case, the streetlight is nicely positioned at the origin, and if I just feed the output of the streetlight into the new transform 3D, look what happens. Boom, a very nice roadside streetlight. But wait, there is more. Since the transformation of the streetlight happens separately, it's also really easy to make a whole bunch of these. Just repeat the process a couple of times. Right-click a tracker, copy its position, and then paste. And you will have a whole row of streetlights with hardly any effort. But what if there are no trackers where you want to put your object? Now here's where the create align shape I mentioned earlier can be a useful tool, but it does have a couple of downsides. But I'll show you that way first before showing my partial solution for this problem. Say you want the car to turn right at a fork in the road, about here. There are no trackers at the crossroad, but there are quite a few surrounding it. So if you take the average position of these trackers, you're going to be pretty close. So let's select a couple of trackers, like so. And then select create aligned shape. By default, Fusion will create a cylinder, but we don't want that. We just want the location and rotation info to position our fork. So now I first have to add a clean transform 3D node. Then copy the shape node. Go to the transform 3D node, right click, paste settings. That puts the fork in its place, but the scaling is way off, so you need to reset that as well. And as a last step, you have to add minus 90 to the X rotation to flip the text right side up again. You can now delete the aligned shape and your fork is positioned very nicely to where you want it to be. But, and now we're back to the original issue, this is a pretty destructive way of doing things. If you want to reposition the fork, you have to create a new aligned shape and go through all these steps to put it back in its place. To make this a little more flexible, I created a modified Transform 3D tool. This tool has three input fields that accept all 3D tools that output 3D positional data. So camera, shapes, locator 3D, etc., and not just point cloud data. What it does is average the three positions of the input fields, and it works like this. For example, in this scene, I have a cube, a torus, and a spear, and a cone. I want to position the cone at the centroid of the three shapes. So I drag the cube, the sphere, and the torus to the three input fields. Now when I connect the cone to the average transform 3D node, you can see it jumps to the average position of the three. When I move one or two or three of these objects, the cone adjusts to stay in the middle of them. This same principle also applies to our previous example of the fork in the road. I can select three points in the point cloud, right click and select create locator. Now when I drag the three locators to the fields, the fork will move to the average position. The current version of this tool doesn't support alignment to the angle yet, but I still think it's a useful tool even in its current incarnation. I admit that these steps don't seem to be that much faster than the original method I demonstrated, but it makes up for it in flexibility. You can create more locators from the point cloud to make it easier to switch between positions. Or you can just right-click a track, copy position, and use the paste settings option to update the locator. The updates are instantaneous. I will put the settings file on my Gumroad page as a DRFX file for Resolve users. Fusion users can install the file in the macro folder, and it will show up inside the Fusion in the macro section of the effects.
So that's it for me for today. I'm currently also working on a macro that makes creating arrows easier. If that's something you're interested in, let me know in the comments below. So like, subscribe, you know the drill, and I'll see you all next Fuseday. Let's keep that fuse burning.